Pulga, and of course our PSDS, Dr. Sara Lumabo. As you may know, this webinar is focused on interim guidelines for assessment and grading in light of the BELCP or the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan. For sure, there will be a lot of changes in the system. So just sit back and relax, and I wish you a fruitful webinar. Thank you and good morning.
Thank you very much, Sir Dante, for that warm welcome to all of the participants of this district webinar. Now let's move on to the opening remarks of our very own elementary school principal two of Tingabulong Elementary School, Sir Junel Rubin. Sir Junel. Of this district wala man sa webinar. Now let's move on to the opening remarks of Junel, our very own elementary school principal two.
Wala. No.
School, Sir Junel. Hello, Sir Junel. Kita mo dia sa kuan attendance na Sir Junel wala. Wala no, bisa ko sana kog lantaw dari yo. Hello. Okay, since Sir Junel is not yet around, so as your moderator, I will announce that our webinar for this morning is officially open. Ayan, ako na lang ni tanan. This time, ladies and gentlemen, again, I'd like to call our very active and hands-on principal of Laureano Salusud National High School, Sir Pedro Langido, for his statement of purpose.
Okay, good morning, especially to our moderator, Sir Yon, to our very supportive, approachable, and very kind service-oriented, workaholic district supervisor, Dr. Sara Ilumabo. To my principal, Hadja Lasida Bunga, to all other principals, school heads, TSS, and teachers. All, good morning. And very kind. I forgot the specific date during the demand during the webinar on division with the webinar about DepEd Order 31. It is mandated during that webinar that each district will going to cascade on the orientation of this DepEd Order 31 entitled Interim Guidelines for Assessment and Grading in Light of the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan. Because we are in the new normal. So based on the DepEd Order 22, DepEd Order 12, the department issues these guidelines which anchor mainly on DepEd Order number 8 entitled Policy Guideline on Classroom Assessment for the K-12 Basic Education Program. So therefore, very clear that this DepEd Orders 8 is still on effect. But then there is a little adjustment of this DepEd order. That's why the division office really required each district to reorient our teachers on the field, because this is one of the very important things that's why we are in the field teaching our students. So I do hope that this will really be absorbed to all our teachers, because the end users of this DepEd order is our teachers. So please make yourself available, especially during the last part of this webinar on the open forum, the question and answer, so that our school heads all together with our district supervisor will try our best to answer your queries. Good morning once again.
Okay, thank you very much, Sir Pedro Langido, for that statement of purpose. Okay, this time, ladies and gentlemen, for the presentation of facilitators and participants, please welcome the head teacher one of Binuay National High School, Dr. Janeline C. Bahian. Janeline, it is now your time. Yeah, ano man ka? Nangawala naman yung mga. Ano naman si Ma'am Janeline? Oh. Hello, Ma'am Janeline. It's your time for the presentation of facilitators and participants. Hello. Huh? Oh, Ion. Huh? Dilik. Merisi ni mo. Dili maon ang imong kuan. Sige. Sorry mga kapatid, another problem na naman. Sir Janeline will not dili daw siya maka on sa iyang microphone. I don't know. But she's also having another webinar with the MNE coordinators. No? So ako rin po ni. Naunsa naman taon ni trabaho. Awarded na jud ko ani ron. So on behalf of Dr. Janeline Bahian, I'd like to present our facilitators for this webinar. Our first speaker will be Ma'am Gina Kabading, who will discuss on the essential features of the Dependent Order 31 Series of 2020. And the second speaker, ako na po, yours truly, will also discuss about the key points on assessment. And the third and last speaker will be Sir Pedro Langido, who will talk about the grading procedures, mga competition. And for the participants, okay, for the participants, please listen. For cluster one, both elementary and secondary, please type one on the chat box. Go. Cluster one, composed of the Mataling Central Elementary School, Poblacion National High School, the Mataling National High School. So I see here four from the central, five. Bakayawan pa rin appeal sa cluster one. High school, I have not seen high school. Inform. Okay. So there we have the participants of cluster one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Thank you very much, cluster one. Now let's proceed to cluster two. Please type two. Cluster two is composed of
Buburay
National High School, Buburay Elementary School, Sumput Elementary School. There we have first honor gets si Rosalie Lamban. Good morning, ma'am. Ayan. Balarote, Buburay National High School. I understand nga dili maka-type ang uban kay gamay-ramay ni sulod. 100 laman nag-iuwa. Managid na kaabot og 200 ini. Ayan. Buburay. Ayan. Meron na tayong Buburay Elementary School. Ma'am Velma, good morning. Sumpot. Wala ko kakitag Sumpot. Rosalie Lamban. Oh, Buburay National High School, Ms. Ma'am Rosalie. Good. Buburay, Sumpot Elementary School. Wala. No participants from Sumpot. Isa lang. Wala, Jud. Sir Julito, Alcachupas. Wala diri sa solo drone. Okay, proceed ta. How about cluster
three? Bro.
Cluster three.
Why signal?
Play signal? Pangita mo signal, saka mo lubi.
Nara ko, wala ko naka-type.
Mambala, please turn off your video. Mambala. Ma'am, paliho ko turn off sa inyong mga video, please. Cluster 3, composed of Tingabulong Elementary School, Tingabulong National High School, Balanagan Elementary, Subay Uno, Kudilog. Okay. 3, just type 3. 3 lang, 3. Ayan, meron na tayong National High School sa Tingabulong, then Elementary. Ang sa Subay, I have not seen any. Ah, Nilda Babor, Subay, Irene Kasokot, yan, Marilo. Marami na. Kudilog. Kudilog. 3. Cluster 3, ba na yung Tipangi? Hindi man siguro cluster 3 na yung Tipangi. Okay, thank you very much. Proceed ta. Cluster 4. Please type 4. Composed of San Miguel Elementary School, Tinikwangan Elementary School, Laureano Salusod National High School. Okay. Dagan-daghan po ang cluster 4. Thank you. Laureano, si Girodel ang naa. Basig isara po ni ka-account ilang gamit. Okay, Carmen Kabasag po na. Okay, thank you. Cluster 5. Please type 5. Cluster 5, Mahayag, Libertad, National High School and Elementary, Tipangi, Mercedes, Upper Lujong. Ang Sambato, ah, ganun sila. April Cluster 5, no? Cluster 5, Sambato. Okay, thank you very much. Cluster 6. Cluster 6, Baluno. Baluno, Lalab, Baha. San Roque? Eight, ano? Cluster 6, ayan, ito na, Baluno. Baluno National High School. Cluster 6, Balainisi, Lawagan. Sir Dante, ha? Cluster 6 ka? Okay, thank you. Cluster 7, Pinoy, Josefina, and Magahis. Ay, balunok naman ni Sir Dante. Sorry. Maudi ay. Ako ganyan na sa'yo, pali. Wag pa ka-move on sa Salawagan, Sir Dan. Okay, sa 7, naadan tayo Binuay Elementary School. Josefina, Ana, si Maria Florimi. Sa Magahis, I have not seen any participant from Magahis. Wala yung nakasulod, bisag isa. Lagi yun, oh. Binuay Ragini Okuan, Josefina. Inay siguro ang signal dito, no? Or masigwa siya. Thank you. Now proceed. The last cluster, 8, Salawagan, Grab, San Roque. Ayan. Cluster 8, naana si Sir Lorenzo Fersas. Good morning, sir. The school head of Salawagan National High School. Grab. Naana si Grab. Ayan, si Charlene Sumili. Okay, so I guess all clusters, all schools are represented. Gawas atong ganina, sinara wala rin nakatype itong Magahis. Si Hinay po ng signal. So to all of us, welcome to our webinar about the assessment and grading procedures. Okay, thank you. Napay nagpahabol, oh, cluster 4. Now this time will be the message of our very own, very approachable, active, generous, tanan na nga mga adjectives ani na ana ni ma'am. Aptik pa jud ka ini siya gitanan nga mo suporta sa tanang schools. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our district supervisor, Dr. Sara Lumabo, for her message. Hello, ma'am.
Sorry. Oh. Go ahead. Hello. Hello, good morning.
Yes, ma'am, good morning.
Aldo mo ba di ay? Nakatawa pa mi diri ni Ana Daniel kay ako mangi touch, di man ni touch screen. To the prime movers or the team of this activity today, headed by the intelligent and very responsible principal of San Miguel Elementary School, Sir Ananias Sahulga, Sir Yuni. I am praying for the approval of redistricting soon. So he will be also become a principal of a center school, which he is also worth. to Sir Jonel Rubin, who is my alter ego in the district, the principal of Tingabulung, and might soon also will become as the PICD of the newly created district in this district, no? Hoping soon by siguro next year. To Madam Gina Kabading, who is very obedient, very lenient, ready all the time. She's a Girl Scout, no? Who will be also saving me, no? Every time if I will ask her to be a facilitator. Don't worry, Ma'am Jean. Anyway, I'm also here, no? Always here so we can share and help one another. To the very workaholic principal of Laureano National High School, who always abide with laws, DepEd orders, memos. As I see, mauni ang principal na hands-on principal, who has so many skills. Dili ra ko kakita nga principal na panday pa, wilder pa, ug uban pa. No? I know he is doing for the welfare of everybody. It's no other than the principal of Laureano, Sir Pedro, who gave the purpose of this seminar a while ago. To Ma'am Jeneline Bahian, who is also very kind, very good, and very active, pero wa nakasulun. It's okay, Ma'am Jeneline. To the very humble and young district ICT coordinator, thank you so much, Mr. Nathaniel Cañas, for you are doing your part. You are starting to be working with us. No, thank you to the principal, to your principal, Sir Yuni, who reminded me to join, to include you in our GC. No, kay importante pud ka kaayo kay mag-unsa ni nga we are not also expert about this computer. To the principal of Dimataling National High School, Ma'am Hadja Lasida Bunga, to Ma'am Napinyas, I cannot see Ma'am Napinyas, naang siya, the principal of Buburay, to the head teachers, head teacher, Ma'am Milita Ibanez, Sir Bagya, to everybody, to all the school heads of elementary and secondary, and the teachers, the 369, I think, teachers of Dimataling, kung nakasulod ba tanan. A blessed morning, a very good Tuesday to everyone. Kumusta ang gabi? May you had sleep well last night. Here we are again, having this virtual meeting, which is not new to us. Having a web is not new to us. Kahit gusto man nating magkita or face to face, but because of our safety, no, let's just be patient. Kahit gusto man tayong magkita, pero hindi natin magawa, no, for our safety. Now, after having been distributing or answering or checking the modules, what would be your next move? You will record the result, you will give grades, you will compute. So what would be time? Nawala? In advance, I already informed ahead in our group chat of the group of school administrators to download this DepEd Order number 31-2020. No, and I have been already telling them to take this during your lock session. So it is known already that all of us have known this. Maybe this is just a refreshing one. Sa katong naghimo jud, ambot lang kahaog na tininoon ba po nga gi-take up sa lock. No? Because you have already downloaded the PED Order 31. This is about the interim guidelines for assessment and grading in light of the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan, your guidance and policy. This is to provide us with the assessment of student learning and in the grading scheme that will be adopted this school year of pandemic 2021. Please hold on because we have the top calibered school administrators to handle all of this. We have our Sir Pedro, the ever mathematicians, to teach you para mapadali ang computation. So please listen, be there in your post until the end. Not all our parents do not have the knowledge. Kung yung iba mayroon man, but they lack their time because they are also working. Not all of them can provide assistance thoroughly. Sometimes ragyud o lakdap-lakdap lang. Bisan mga head teacher, principal na or supervisor do not even have time to be a teacher at home, no? So malugos na gyud ang ubang ginikanan ana kay mahilap na ang mga bata. But how would they know of the answers if their children is right or wrong? Biro nyo ang mga parents ngayon ginawa nating teacher, no? To localize. Our learners need time, effort, and emotion, and mental capacity. Mauna na hinuon if mautong reason so other districts nga, na atoy districts nga, district nga, gihimong rason na anagyo'y naghikog, pero daladala ra siguro to eh, dili gyud ingon na maugyod to'y hinungdan. No? Let's reconsider our learners in this time of pandemic. Ayaw paghadluka ang mga estudyante, no? We are not to add difficulty to our parents. Think of what extension or help we can contribute. Tulungan natin sila. Let's think of more better ways, not necessarily with the use of the SLMs. Compliance of the modules is not necessarily getting 100% of the modules provided. So, kinahanglan yun, panat yun ang mga bata, mag-answer yun, hindi, yeah, rabadun sila ang nag-answer po siguro. This is not for all, no? Sometimes ang nag-answer, na ay tutor, na ay gibayran, na ay mama, no? So, it wouldn't be a basis in giving their grades ang module, no? Because it's already expected that the learners will get 100% kung nakugay lang gid siya o nakakita lang gid siya sa answer key, no? So the answer key is there. What would be the purpose of putting the answer key is to let them know if their answers are also correct or wrong. Dili po tong diretso na jud na answer na lang gid tan-awon, pero naapoy bubugoy nga ang anak jud ang gihimo. Kaya gikapoy na tungod sa kadaghan, no? All subject or learning areas na agutan na so na muban naga na lang sa answer key. To be clarified, let us be guided with this DepEd Order Number 31. We need time to adjust of this situation that we are facing. Understand the people around us in compliance and addressing answer to our clients and achieving the goals. Now, teachers, please be patient. No, as we hear, have suspended for a week, no, on the distribution of modules. So there are those teachers or schools nga nahuman na naapoy wala pa nahuman. So no worries. Kung nahuman na, then we will be doing the next move. If wala pa nahuman og answer, wala pa nahuman og retrieve, then continue. Dili kay sigin-sigingon po nato. Now we have also to give consideration because of the situation. Because other districts, no, yesterday, when I went to the division office, there are those also PSDSS who asked the assistant schools division superintendent what would be their next move na wala naman ang mga modules, wala na pwede abot nga mga modules unsa na isunod na step na buhaton. So later, maybe today or tomorrow, there will be an instruction. But naana ko'y feedback na nadungog, no, from the mouth of our Assistant Schools Division Superintendent, Ma'am Bisminda Balde, because she read to me the text or the chat of our Schools Division Superintendent. What would be the next step that the teachers will be doing? Na wala naman, nahurot naman ang modules, na humanapod og answer. So, ang tubag ato ni Ma'am is maghatag og mga additional nga mga inputs, maghimo og mga activities, or you can use the books, no? So it depends on the teacher. Ang uban magkuan na sa mga grading o unsaon. So for us, we are still ongoing because we are late for a week or 2 weeks because of the suspension that our distribution in the distribution of our modules. Congrats, and let's be thankful to God. We are all still alive and kicking, doing the responsibility despite of the crisis. I am also congratulating in advance to all of you, and I know you and me will be successful in this undertaking today. Good luck to everyone, and Merry Christmas, and I love you all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sara Lobabo, for inspiring everyone. In this time of health crisis, still we are able to deliver the basic services, education services to all learners. Okay, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Salamat, ma'am. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. We are done with our preliminaries. But before that, shout out muna tayo sa ating mga participants ngayon, especially to Ma'am Sara.
Hi.
Tungkol sa ka-aktibo ani niya, diri kini siya natulog gabi eh. Okay, para maka-prepare gid siya. And daghan po kasi lagi fix ng mga problems sa mga reports. Muna ibiliban ako ng Sara. Basta kayo na ay urgent ng mga reports or sa pananiya, tulugan gina niya diri sa district. Okay, shout out po ta sa mga principal karon, sa mga school heads, wala kasulod. Tungod sa signal. Og sa mga teachers karon nga mikat-kat sa lubi or niadto sa buntod para lang makasignal, kaluoy sa mga teachers padayon nga laban lang ta ani mga igsoon. Mao naman kini atong nga kuan karon, and sa other also teachers nga siguro karon pa nakapamahaw na pa siguro uban diha walay ligo. na wala pakaligo ba. And maligo pa lang din, ipakusga na lang ang speaker para makadungog sa webinar. O ba, nagkaon-kaon rin po diha, nangapi pa. Okay. So again, good morning sa tanan. Atong mga, balik kukuan sa atong mga school heads, elementary and secondary. I hope nga katong mga wala kasulod sa link in your school, kung naaman mo sa eskwelahan karon, just like Sir Julito, murag gausa gid sila, no? Antod wala na lang nun lang attendance. Gausa sila sa eskwelahan, murag isa lang account ilang gipasulod din. Naminaw lang sila sa speaker. Sir, bro, i-type daw imo ang cluster da, bro. Kayo wala ka sa attendance. Okay, sa tanan-tanan nga teacher, nasa bukid karon ga. Oh. Okay. So get ready as we start our session proper. But before that, ako sang kulitugon ng inyong mga utok karon. Let's rev up our minds. Let's prepare our minds so that we'll be able to absorb everything, every information, updates with regards to the assessment and grading procedures for this school year 2020-2021. Brain, kwa sa ta? Kanang tatawag na. nasa tay napihata ninyo nga puzzle, okay, para ma-ready ang ato mga minds. O dili pod makulbaan ato first speaker. Okay, so the challenge now is what we call the Rebos puzzle. Kung kinsa to'y naswito ani, daghan na naswito guro ani, but I'd like to share this to you that Rebos puzzles, also known as word picture puzzles or picture riddles, used to use images, letters, numbers, or words to convey a phrase or message, typically common idiom or expression. So to help you solve this, make sure to look at the word placement, the size, the color, and quantity. And take your time and don't give up. This can be pretty tricky. Now, mechanics. As I flash the picture puzzle, I'd like you to chat your answer on the chat box before I will reveal the answer. Okay? I'd like everyone to participate. Paunhan na ini. Tagaan ni Ma'am Sarah ang pinakataas og points. Tagaan niya premium. Naapay dagang kuan dito premium. Wala na hatag at during our team building. So, i-chat lang inyong mga answer. Okay, there you go. Start. Let's start. Sadi man makuan. Okay. This one. Unsa may answer ninyo? Itabi, kisa una mag-answer sa chat box. Sige daw. Wala yung may answer. Nang left naman yung uban. Ay, lisod yung kaya signal. Ah, daghanak ayo. Wala. Naatay, try to stand, try to understand. Lahi yung answer, no? Duha ka version. Try to stand and try to understand. What else? Who else have the other answer? Are you sure? Sure na ba mo aning answer? Wala na. Okay. So the correct answer for this is ikaw na itali ang inyong correct answer, ha. Dili na ko makuan, dili na ko magamitan og kining slideshow kay magamit ko slideshow, dili ko kita sa inyong mga answer. That is why I will just pronounce.
Sir Yon, permission to interrupt, Sir Yon.
Yes.
Sir Yon, nag-chat ang taga Dimataling dire kang Sir Bagya. They are very kuan, they have difficulty to join the platform. So I think I suggest that some of the schools that have mini slots joining this platform. Atong tagaan o gamayang slots ang Dimataling National High School. They cannot anymore get inside our platform, even one of them.
97 pa man ang participants na kasulod.
Iba 97 pa lang, sir.
Kabot man 100 kapin or 200 bang gani.
I believe base dito sila nagpabilin, sir, yon sa kuan. Atong unang link, base wala sila nadala sa ikaduhang link.
Nag-chat
kedua kali sir Bing, kedua.
Hello. Hello,
good morning. Sige, yon, sir yon, ako tulang taon pa, sigula sila kasulod sa bagong aling.
Hello, good morning. Padungo yes, ko.
Sir Janelle, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. Live mangu karon sa kuan sa ni. Yes. Sa YouTube.
Nang anong ga live man.
Yes, ang uban mangu na sa YouTube ning log in. It's because atong platform mangod is 100 ra ka participants ang accommodate.
Ah, baba. Kayon,
nag-post na ko sa kuan sa ICT group na narin ko ang link sa YouTube.
Division na nga kuan account?
Yes, sa division kay dili man ta makakuan sa atong account god, only the division can do the live streaming through YouTube.
Dayon, anybody can join or can view dito.
Yes, of course, sa YouTube. Kasend na ko sa link dito sa akin. Please help disseminate.
Isa dili taga Dimataling.
Dili sa Dimataling, exclusive for Dimataling only.
Ah, exclusive for Dimataling lang na?
Oo, oo.
Sige. Okay, sige, thank you. So, wala na, padayo na ta. The correct answer, the answer for this puzzle is try to understand. Dili try to stand, try to understand. Congratulations sa nakakorrect. Next. Ay, nabuang na, nagamay. Okay, that one. Congrats sa naka-answer ganina. This one, what's your answer for this puzzle? Maghatag lang ko ninyo mga lima. Daghan pa ko gi-prepare pero lima lang sa. Unya na natay time. Okay, nanatay answer diri. I believe in you, I believe you, unbelievable. Wow. Sa pa, tulo ra ka buok anak answer. Mga pride din taga ni Mataling. Okay, answer man dayon. Lang sa kay correct aning answer. Same ra paska sagaran pareho ra. Wow. Murag kuan ni kay ilang mga otokrono gana jud kayo. Okay, majority of the answers are pare-pareho gyud. I believe in you. Okay? So, the answer for this puzzle is congratulations. I believe in you. Okay. I believe in you. Katong wala dili kayo, wala pa kayo kakuha sa mechanics. Ano na, I believe in you, ana. Try to check, try to look at the picture. Diba na ay I, sa sulod, yun na apoy B, kanang buyog, yun na ay dahon, leaf, or leaf. So, I believe in you. Ano na ay nasila sa sulod sa you. Muna ang answer, I believe in you. Next, this one. Sige. Ah, Leslie Taog. Oh, mo yung una naka-answer. Ayan. Followed by Yvonne Jane, din Nathaniel, Labandiro, Lucelle. Ayan. So, yun rakay no? Dali rakay no? Okay. Okay, the answer for this is congratulations, once in a blue moon. Okay. Kine, last na lang ni kay aron mo start ta sa session 1. Ipadayon na nato unya dapit pag natay time. Kada every after session. Ah, tika kayo na ka. Ano? Perfect, not perfect. Ayaw mo pang upya. Masi di na mau answer. Okay. There you go. Okay, last na lang, last. Okay, the answer for this is 4 instants. Congratulations. Asa may ako ikaw na. Kini. Last na lang eh, kayo makusita sa session 1. Eh murag, gana naman kaya itong mga utok. Wow. Ang una naka-answer si Ma'am La Arne, check to check. Sige daw. Ang uba, ano sa answer ninyo? Cheek to cheek. Kay Michelle Labandero. Sa pa. Majority sa answer is cheek to cheek. Wala na? No more, no more. Ang uban ani kay dili man maka-type kay naminaw ra man wala man sila nakasulod sa. Kan okay ra. Okay. Chikitita. Chikitita ni Gopa, Irene. Double check, check a cheek. Okay, the answer for this is turn the other cheek. Ayan. Turn the other cheek. Congratulations sa nakakuha og correct answer na si Aileen Tao, Leslie Tao. Turn the other cheek. As you can see, ang isa ka cheek diya, i-turn. Ay-ray arrow. So turn the other cheek. Nel, unsay problema, Nel? Unsay dili makita ang screen? Saan man ni siya?
Wala magoy kwan sa kwan yon sa live stream. Naka screen share man kano. Ikuan ko na siya yon kanang sini so, kanang press ima ba.
Dili makita ni. Dili makita ang kwan sa presentation dito.
Wala.
Nang saan man ni? Di ko baluan ni.
Eh. Anak kanay click na sige daw.
Anak, kaning anak, makita dito.
Wala gihapon. Sige lang sila, makikoordinate lang ko sa division. Sige, Jun. Padayon lang.
Okay, sige. So, padayon lang taani ato ang Rebos puzzle mamaya every after session. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I'd like to welcome our first speaker for this morning's webinar, our principal of Binuay Elementary School, who will tackle about essential features of Deputy Order 31 Series of 2020. Please welcome Ma'am Lucretia Cabadin. Okay.
Hello, good morning. Good morning, maririnig po ba ako?
Good morning, ma'am. Loud and clear.
Okay, thank you, Sir Pez. Sa ating tagapangasiwang pampurok, the gorgeous Dr. Sara Lumabo, principals, school heads, and teachers of both elementary and secondary schools, my salute to all of you. Magandang buhay po at Merry Christmas. So this morning, I would like to share with you the interim guidelines for assessment and grading in light with the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan or DepEd Order Number 31 Series 2020. So the rationale, as stated in DepEd Order Number 8/2015. The policy guidelines in classroom assessment for the K-12 basic education program. Assessment should be used to inform and improve classroom practices and promote learning outcomes. However, in distance or blended learning environments, it is necessary to utilize alternative tools and strategies for assessing and supporting learning, while avoiding creating and do pressure on the teachers, learners, and their families. So ang DepEd Order po number 31 ay nakaangkla sa DepEd Order number 8 Series 2015. Mayroon lamang pong pagbabago na inakma sa modality na ginamit natin ngayon. Para po hindi mahirapan ang mga guro, kabataan at lalong-lalo na po ang mga parents facilitator natin. So it is imperative for school to take child assessment and grading practices that will most meaningfully support our learners. That's why the DepEd issues the interim policy guidelines for assessment and grading. So ano po ba ang saklaw ng DO31? So the scope. So this DepEd order provides for the interim policy guidelines for assessment and grading in light of the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan that will be implemented by public elementary and secondary schools nationwide this school year 2020-2021. So private schools, technical and vocational institutions, and higher educational institutions, including state and local universities and colleges, offering the K-12 basic education program, are encouraged to implement this interim policy guidelines as well. So while DO number 8, or DepEd order number 8, series 2015, is still in effect, provisions inconsistent with this, new guidelines are suspended for this school year. And private schools and institutions are permitted to modify these policy guidelines with the approval of the DepEd regional offices. Now let's proceed to the definition of terms. So we have here the summative test. So it is an assessment that is usually administered toward the end of a grading period to measure the extent to which the learners have mastered the essential learning competencies, the results of which are recorded and are used to report the learner's achievement. While grading is the way of reporting assessment data by assigning a value to the results as a record of students' ability, achievement, or progress. Classroom assessment. So it is an ongoing process of identifying, gathering, organizing, and interpreting quantitative and qualitative information about what learners know and can do. While formative assessment is a process that involves teachers using evidence about what learners know and can do to inform and improve their teaching. This process, through the teacher's immediate feedback, enables students to take responsibility for their own learning and identify areas where they do well and where they need help. So ang mga definition na to ay hindi ko na po tahasang ipapaliwanag isa-isa dahil paulit-ulit na po ito. Ito po ay napapaloob sa ating LDM 2, Learning Delivery Modalities 2 course for teachers na bago-bago pa lang po natin sinumite ang ating mga outputs. So alam ko po nabihasa na po ang lahat tungkol sa mga terms na nauukol sa assessment. So let's proceed to this caricature. So look at the caricature. Kung makikita po ninyo, natatakot yung bata. Parang lula yata yung nagtatanong. So, what did you learn at home today? So, takot yung bata. Parang natatakot siya sa lula niya. So, hindi lang dapat matigil hanggang sa pagbibigay natin ng modules. So, dapat din nating kumustahin ang mga kabataan natin sa kanilang mga bahay-bahay. Now, have you conducted kumustahan with our learners remotely? So it is important to check our learners at least once a week. It can provide us vital information on how our learners are adjusting in the new learning process. If once a week may be a challenge, then you can opt to do it once in every 2 weeks. Sa pamamagitan po ng kumustahan, makakabuo tayo ng meaningful connections with our learners. Mapaparamdam natin ang ating concern para sa kanila. So kailangan po natin silang tawagan, i-text, or i-message sa chat, mga messenger ninyo. Hindi lang yung mga bata, kundi pati na rin yung mga magulang natin. Kukumustahin din natin yung paano sila naging nag-guide ng kanilang mga anak in answering the self-learning modules. Now, in choosing assessment methods, so there are questions that we need to consider when deciding on which assessment methods to use. So we have to consider the following questions. First, what is the purpose of the assessment? So pagpili mo ng methods, dapat ito, number one, alam mo yung purpose ng assessment. Then what will be assessed? Next, which method would best allow learners to demonstrate what they have learned considering their learning modality? Then which method would make it easy to gather evidence of learners' progress over time? So ngayon po, madali po natin gamitin ang kanilang portfolio as evidence. Will the assessment be completed individually or in groups? So sa kasalukuyan, mahihirapan po tayo kung group assessment kasi po nasa bahay-bahay lang yung mga bata. So madali ang individual assessment. Will the assessment be taken at the same time or submitted within a specific period? So nagbibigay tayo ng modules kasi modules naman yung ginagamit natin ngayon. Magbibigay tayo ng Lunes tapos ibabalik din pagdating ng Lunes. Yung iba, yung sa amin o sa atin dito, mas marami yung nagbibigay ng modules, nagbibigay ng assessment, sabay na yung assessment, binigay sa Friday, tapos kukunin pag next Friday. Pero hindi lang yun, pag mayroon ding mga bata na hindi nakakatapos, pwede rin nating bigyan ng oras para makatapos sila sa kanilang test. Now, next, how will class size affect the way the assessment will be conducted? So ang class size din ay kailangan. Isipin mo rin kung gaano karaming bata. Then, how can technology help? So those are the important questions that we need to consider when deciding on which assessment methods to use. So in planning the assessment, we have the formative assessment. So it establish formative assessment should establish clear learning targets and success criteria. Letter B, it elicit useful evidence of learning. It provides timely and effective feedback. It engages learners in assessing and improving each other's work and increase ownership of their own learning. So assessment is integral for understanding student learning and development. Therefore, we teachers must uphold the integrity of learning and instruction and ensure that all learners are fairly assessed and learning standards shall be attained. A variety of assessment strategies is necessary in capturing the attainment of the most essential learning competencies. With formative assessment, taking priority to inform teaching and promote growth and mastery. Giving immediate feedback is also necessary. Formative assessment should be specific, frequent, and it should target skills necessary to the attainment of learning competencies as measured in the summative assessment. Let's proceed. Summative assessment continue in the form of written works and performance tasks. So written work shall be administered to assess essential knowledge and understanding through quizzes and long unit tests, while performance tasks refer to the assessment tasks that allow learners to show what they know and are able to do in diverse ways. They may create or innovate products or do performance-based tasks, skill demonstrations, group presentations, oral work, multimedia presentations, and research projects. It is important to note that written outputs may also be considered as performance tasks. So to evaluate learning at particular points in each quarter, summative assessment shall continue in a form of written works and performance tasks. So learners must be given flexibility in the accomplishment of the performance tasks to consider the resources available to them. So let's look at letter C. Nakasulat dyan, flexibility in accomplishment of the performance task to consider time and resources available to them. Sa pagbibigay po natin ng performance task, dapat po i-localize po natin. Kung galing po sa Manila, yung mga modules, may mga materials po doon. Sorry. May mga resources na hindi po available sa atin. So, dapat i-localize. So, tayo po mga guro ang mag-isip kung paano natin mapabuti o paano natin mabigyan ng performance task yung mga bata kung saan ang resources ay makikita lang dito sa ating lugar. Hindi na po kailangan bibili kung saan-saan pa. Teachers must exercise their professional judgment in carrying out summative assessments, providing enough opportunities for learners to practice and to redo their work whenever necessary so that they can reach their learning targets with a less amount of pressure. In communicating the assessment remotely or in communicating the assessment tasks, teachers must ensure that the following details are explained. What are these details in conducting assessment remotely? Letter A, objectives of the assessment task. The rules of learners and parents or guardians, procedure and expected timeline, then the standards and rubrics. Explain po natin ito, itong apat na ito. So teachers should set realistic expectations. What is effective and what is feasible to accomplish? Explain also the roles of the learners and parents as the facilitator. We should encourage our parents to stay connected with the learners as guide on this side in order to give guidance and supervision. So iklaro po natin, yung parents, they are guide. Dili sila ang mag-answer sa modules, kay guide lang yun sila sa mga bata. Their role as parent-teacher is very critical. Therefore, we should encourage them to be more patient. And the collection and recording of evidences of learning is integral for monitoring student learning and development. So listed are some sample strategies for this purpose. So in recording of progress, there are three sample strategies. Letter A is the self-monitoring tool. I-explain po ito mamaya ng ating next speaker. Then the check-ins of teacher with learner during assessment period. And the evidence of learning in the student's learning portfolio. So lahat po ng activities na makikita nila, sasagutan nila sa self-learning modules ay magiging parte po yon ng student's learning portfolio. Feedback and remediation. So in giving feedback, teachers need to maximize available communication options. Example, writing feedback and the output. Texting feedback via SMS and using online channels. So hindi na natin hihintayin kung kailan pa kasi dapat ang feedbacking ay timely. So sulat agad, text agad, magtatanong through SMS. So consistent with DO number 8 series 2015, teachers should ensure that learners receive remediation when they earn raw scores which are consistently below expectation in summative assessments by the fifth week of any quarter. This will prevent a student from failing in any learning area at the end of the school year. So hindi din po ito bago sa atin ang remediation. So pag may hindi makapasa, kung may nahihirapan, hindi nakaabot ng 75, so dapat bigyan po ng remediation. So ito po ang mabigat na trabaho ng mga guro, lalong-lalo na po sa panahon natin ngayon. So paano tayo makapag-remediate ng mga kabataan? Lalong-lalo na yung mga scores nila, eh hindi rin natin sigurado kung sino ang sumasagot. Kung parents ba o yung bata ba. Paano kung nagkamali din yung parents sa pagtuturo. Pero ang mahalaga, eh ginagawa nila yung kanilang trabaho sa bahay na tuturuan yung mga bata. Dahil nga modules yung ginagamit natin. So, rating works and performance tasks, they shall be administered to assess the content and performance standards that describe the knowledge, abilities, and skills that learners are expected to demonstrate. So, in the grading and promotion, students' learning portfolio documents all the evidence of learning within the grading period, including self-reflections, self-evaluations of performance tasks guided by rubrics, and self-selected best outputs in learning modules. So magpili din ang pinaka-best na outputs. Yung galing sa regional natin na module, may ready-made na mga performance tasks guided already with rubrics. May mga rubrics na doon, so hindi na po mahihirapan yung mga guro. So letter B, minimum of 4 written works and 4 performance tasks within the quarter, preferably 1 in 2 weeks, integrating 2 or more learning modules. Again, minimum of 4 written works and 4 performance tasks within the quarter, preferably 1 in 2 weeks, integrating 2 or more learning modules. Yun po ang ibibigay natin sa assessment. So, apat lang. Apat na reading works, apat na performance tasks, and preferably 1 in 2 weeks. Sa kada duha ka semana, maghimo na tag-assessment. So, duha ka semana, isa ka-assessment. All competencies should be covered by the performance tasks. So, lahat ng competencies, lahat ng nasa MELC, lahat na nasa modules dapat ma-covered yung sa 2 weeks. Example, performance tasks can be used to assess science, math, and English all together for a certain topic. So, integrated lang yung tatlong subjects, pwede. So, kung anong mga subject na pwede integrate, makakagawa na kayo ng isang performance task sa tatlong subject. So, pili na lang kayo mga guro. So, kayo na po ang bahala na kung alin doon sa mga competencies ang pwede ma-integrate. Pero sa binigay po na self o sa SLM, so, nandun na yung mga competencies, lalong-lalo na yung sa regional office galing. Naka-integrate na po. Let's proceed to my last topic, which is all about the rubrics. So, rubric is a learning and assessment tool that is used to evaluate written outputs, products, or performance-based tasks. It is a scoring guide that articulates the expectations and describes the levels of quality expected from a learner. And there are 4 essential features of rubrics. So, dili man nilisod kay, sige naman ato nang gigamit ning rubrics. So, there are 4 essential features of rubrics. First, the task description or a descriptive title of the task students are expected to produce or perform. Second, a scale and scoring that describes the level of mastery. Example, exceed expectation, meets expectation, or doesn't meet expectation. That is the scale or scoring. Third feature is the components criteria. So students are to attend to in completing the assignment or task, the types of skills, and the knowledge. And the last is the description of the performance quality. Performance descriptor of the components, dimensions at each level of mastery. So there are 4 essential features in making rubrics. Now, what are the benefits of these rubrics? So there are 2 rubrics. There are 2 types, analytic or holistic rubric. For analytic rubric, it articulates different dimensions of performance and provides ratings for each criterion or dimension. What is the advantage of using this analytic rubric? So first criterion can be weighted and scored. They take less time to create than a holistic rubric. In an analytic rubric, you can provide feedback on areas of strengths and weaknesses. Now, for holistic rubric, it describes the overall characteristic of a performance and provides a single score. And the advantage of using this holistic rubric is that it provides a specific feedback on its criterion. It provides feedback on what the learner is able to demonstrate, what he or she cannot do or can do. There are also advantages of using the rubrics. For students, it helps them understand your expectations and it inspire better performance. While for the teachers, it makes scoring easier and faster, accurate and biased and consistent. So this is an example of a holistic rubric. So tingnan natin ang kanyang essential features. The title, portfolio grading, and the description. This rubric is designed to evaluate the portfolio submission based on content, presentation of work, and reflection. So nandyan yung scoring, then nandyan din yung performance descriptor. So ang wala dyan sa holistic rubric ay ang components criteria. So hindi po natin makikita. Performance descriptor ang nandyan. Another example for analytic rubric, the title is all about the math problem solving rubric. The description, nandyan. So dito sa analytic rubric, andyan na yung components criteria. So yung components criteria, makikita below dimension. Nandyan rin yung scaling, yung pagbibigay ng points. So hindi ko na yan mabasahin isa-isa. Master na kayong lahat sa paggawa ng rubrics dahil palagi na itong ginagamit sa klase natin. At nasa sa inyo na rin mga teachers kung aling type ang gusto nyong gamitin. Analytic or holistic rubric. Nasa sa inyo na po yun. Ay, nahumanak ko. Okay, assessments should compare the performance of students to a set of expectations, never to the performance of other students. From Alfie Khan. Thank you and Merry Christmas, everyone.
Thank you so much, our first speaker in the person of Ma'am Lucretia Cabading of Binuay Elementary School. Okay. Wala lagi. For a while. Yeah. Hello. Napa ba tadi atanan? Hello. Those who are turning on their video, please turn it off. Ma'am, listening na kaguan. Okay na. Okay. Karo pa ba akong tingog game mic on?
Loud and clear. Okay, klaro pa, klaro.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, we are done with our session one about these essential features of the Depoid Order number 31, series of 2020. Now, if you have some queries or clarifications with regards to this session or this matter, I'd like you to jot down your questions, and then later part of this webinar, we will be having our open forum or question and answer that would be answered by our very own district supervisor later. So ipark sa natin yung mga questions ha, para proceed lang ta sa atong two more topics for this morning webinar. Okay, thank you very much, Ma'am Gina, for the very comprehensive explanation on the essential features of the DepEd Order number 31. Okay, before proceeding to the next topic, ayan, magkuan na punta sa ato ang okay, sa ato ang challenge, the Rebus Puzzle Challenge. Okay. Labas, mga genius. At sa ato mga good morning also and welcome to our YouTube viewers, no? Nakaroon sa, di naman sila kasulod sa ato nga link sa Google Meet. So na sila karon naglantaw, naminaw sa ato nga live streaming via YouTube. Good morning to all of you. Welcome to this webinar. And then for you to answer this puzzle, pwede mo mag-answer gyapon diya sa comment section. And then you have to self-correct na lang. Ikaw na lang mag-check diha sa inyong mga answers. Nagka-bright na jug maayo ni atong mga participants, oh. get out lagi. Okay. So the correct answer is forgive and forget. Ana lamang ginamaigsoon. Kinahanglan nga kay balo puta mapasaylo kay dili maayo nga makinabuhi ta nga naay kaligot-got sa atong mga kasing-kasing. Ah. In kalimtan na lang pud nato ang mga kasakit nga atong gibati, gihambin atong mga miaging panahon. Okay, this one. What's your answer? Wala pa? Wala pa isa? Sige, sige. Think. Nana isa. Red face. Oh, kinsa pa? Unsa pa itong unaunaan? Red face. Red face, mura ka to ning nasubraan og lipstick. Kinsa na kay daghang correct anino? Daghang mga correct responses, ilista ninyo diha kay naay premium. Okay, so the correct answer is red in the face. So mali po yung mga sagot ninyo na red face. Red in the face. Ayan ha. Pag mali po ang walang mga na ay kulang bisag isa lang ka word, mali yun na siya. Red in the face. Next, this one. Sige, participate para dili ta katulgon diha. Wala na. Naglag. Oh, nanay ni answer. Bright kining ano, dali kay nakatubag ning atong ICT district ICT coordinator. Ambot kag sakto ba kali ang answer? Atay rectangle na lang for a change. Loading. What left must right. Attendance is a must. John Lord, attendance is a must. Mao gyud no? Sa YouTube ka karon na ba kay nag-answer ron dito? Unsa naman ay I left the group. Unsa naman ning mga kuan gi pag-answer uban? Okay. Hirit na hirit. Okay, the correct answer for this is pass naman uning but the correct answer is what goes up must come down. Congratulations, Nathaniel Canias. Wow. Sir Nathan Regina ka correct. What goes up? Tanawa ang what, diba? Ni goes up. Then must come down. Alright. Kine. The best part. The best part of this puzzle. Ngayon, grade 1 teacher ko. Alphabet na yun. Irene. Guapa. Kalisod ba? Sayon naman ko kayo na. Ano ba yun na? Sequel pa alphabet lagi. Irene, alphabet ra daw na. Letters in the box. Lingaw yun sila.
Missing you.
A to Z. A, B, C, D. Alphabet letters, capital letters of the alphabet. Oh, nanapunin ko ano. Great to teacher, oh, Ma'am Nida. Correct you ka, Ma'am. Capital letters, gina siya of the alphabet. Okay, the correct answer for this puzzle is, congrats sa nakakorek, missing you. Gimingaw na jud kay kunimo. Dugay na tawa nakita kay sigilaga ICQ. Congratulations. Kine. Yan. Ato sang kuno tong una una kita sa pamabutag oras. Duha na lang ka topic. Mubo ra po tong akong topic man. Congrats. Nathaniel, kinsa pinakuha? Kini nga puzzle, what's the answer ninyo? Ikaw lagi unatan. Genre mo pahabol pala siya. Okay, we have here answer. You're in action. Na apo tay ni answer og reduction na surrender man ni ka genre ayaw surrender diha. Reduce, recycle, reduction. Pwede kikini si kwan ay Irene, si Irene. Okay, the correct answer for this puzzle is reduction. Red man, di ba? Kita niyo red. So, reduction. Congrats. This one. Horror with Budbud. Kaayo ra, horror with Budbud daw. Sakto ka ning answer eh. Irene? Okay. Sige, last na lang. Ano, pwede doha. Correct answer for this is Robin Hood. Robin Hood, congrats, Janre and Nathaniel. Kine? This one, what's your answer? kuntis gini mga Salusod family oh. For life. Life begins at 40. Life starts at 40. Life starts at 40. Life begins at ayo no may kaayod. So the answer is life begins at 40. Last one. Okay, proceed sa session 2. Mga 30 minutes ra po niya kuha or ipak about 30 minutes. Our last puzzle. We have here from Laarni, correction. So far sa tanan nga kong flash no, isa ra'y wala nang sira ninyo no? Sa itong, kuha na ganun na? Daw ba kini kay murag kuan ni siya very tricky haha answer genre haha any answer operation incomplete operation sapa uban correction. Operation tuli. Operation tuli again. Subtraction, addition. Okay, hirit. Okay, we start the session 2. Generation, napay na paabot o generation. So I guess, murag walay nakakorek o walay nakakuha correct answer. The correct answer for this puzzle is painless operation. Painless. Kanatanil, hapit-hapit na, no pain. No pain operation. Okay, so all the audience, silingan rin sila. Painless operation. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Now, let's proceed to the next speaker. Ang usa sa pinakagwapo ng mga na school heads sa Dimataling District. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome. Ini siya ang pinakagwapo. Okay, ako na po, ako na kaya po ni. Superhero na kita ni mga Ikson. So my session is all about the key points on assessment. Okay? Some of the points or key points for this session were already tackled by Ma'am Gina. Na dito dapit ko Ma'am Gina ang uban ani nga mga kuan mga items nga na adiri na appeal ani key points on assessment. Okay? So padayon ta. Magseryoso na punta. Okay, this is our session 2. Welcome to our session 2 about key points on assessment. Assessing student learning in light of the basic education learning continuity plans. A while ago, our first speaker discussed about the essential or the essential features on the DepEd Order 31 series of 2020. This is only a continuation. All right. Now, the DepEd is committed to ensure the educational continuity in this time of crisis, while looking after the health, safety, and well-being of all our learners, teachers, and personnel. That is why, in our school, we are really required to prepare our school in terms of the safety precautions and health protocols, no? Just like sa atong ginahimo sa atong classrooms, arrange gid kayo ang room, asa dapit ibutang ang module, asa dapit kuhaon ang module, teachers, and then teachers table. Teachers tables have barriers na ay mga cellophane nga nakababag. Pero nga dili gid daw makit-an sa virus. Okay, so safety protocols in returning, in the distribution of or submission of the modules by the parents, it must be strictly implemented. We are all guided with these protocols. Okay, so the schools must adapt assessment and grading practices that can most meaningfully support student development and respond to variety or varied contexts at this time. So these are the guiding principles in the assessment that we are having now in our time, in this time of, or the kind of learning modality that we are now implementing in our division. The first principle is assessment should be holistic and authentic in capturing the attainment of most essential learning competencies. Discuss. No? I don't know. So na appeal na ni kanina ni Ma'am Gina. So when we say, so as much as possible, it should measure the whole of the child's learning. When we say holistic, whole ni siya, dili siya holy ha, balaan. Basig ma misinterpret nato ni. Holistic means the whole. Kinatibukan. So this assessment should measure the whole of the child's learning. And then authentic in a way that these learning competencies that we consider essential or important will be developed and demonstrated by the child in his or her daily life to the community that he or she is in. No? So dapat, diba atong purpose is ma-master sa bata ang skill or competency and that he or she could be use it in the community, sa iyang daily life or day-to-day interaction with the people in the community. Okay. So second is assessment is integral for understanding student learning development. Remember that assessment will actually help learners develop a sense of independence, no? So you need to be aware of this. Third one, a variety of assessment strategies is necessary. With formative assessment taking priority to inform teaching and promote growth and mastery. When you do formative assessment, you should try to use not just one strategy. Ilang ka isa lang atong gamiton kung maghatag ta formative assessment. No? But instead, use a variety or diverse strategies that will really help the learners learn and develop the skill or skills that we want them to demonstrate. So kita teachers dapat creative ta in making or giving assessment, formative, especially formative assessment. Dili lang kay isa lang ka pamaagi nga gabalik-balik lang na gasige lang ka gahatag og paper pencil test, no? So maura mahuna-una ato nga assessment, gabalik-balik ng paper pencil as it hantud na mapul-an ang mga bata. So we must be creative, resourceful to give or to provide various or variety of assessment strategies. Number four, assessment and feedback should be a shared responsibility among teachers, learners, and their families. So assessment is not just the work of the teacher, but rather it's a shared responsibility among the teachers, learners, and their families, especially the kind of learning modality that we are having right now, the parents or the immediate family play a vital role in promoting child's learning. Okay, wala man sa atuwa ang bata, wala man sa eskwilahan. Wala man tayo face-to-face instruction nila. So ang mga ito mga ginikanan and other members of the family, mo'y dako dyo kayo o ng role to develop learning or to give learning to our pupils through the use of our learning, self-learning modules. That is why we as teachers, kailangan natin na tulungan din natin mga parents or the guardians na mo'y nag-assist sa mga bata. I just hope that you, even though we don't have a face-to-face instruction, I'm just hoping that you do have a constant or regular communication with our parents, especially pag naa sila yung mga pangutana. Dili lang siguro ta nga magtagad lang ta, nga tawagan ta sa atong mga ginikanan, siguro ato po na, ato kita na mismo ang mutawag nila. Try to follow up. What's the status, the updates? Unsay problema nila sa ilang modules, unsay problema sa mga bata. Okay. So number five, assessment and grading should have a positive impact on learning. So without this, assessment may be useless if it doesn't have any impact on to learning. Remember that assessment is the reins that support the learning of the child. Just like the rein of the horse, kana bitong rinda sa kuan ba sa kabayo, no? Pinaagi sa rinda, magiyahan nimo ang kabayo asa siya paingon, asa left right ba siya, muliko ba siya, o pakusgo nimo sana niya. O pareho ra nang anak. So it provides guidance, kini aso ang assessment, it provides guidance in a way to put learning, in the right path. Okay. So the desired outcomes. Teachers, the school leaders, the school heads, atong learners, atong mga ginikanan must commit, no, to uphold the integrity of learning and instruction in the context of distance education. So these are the desired outcomes of this policy. The first is to ensure that, ini mo na argya po niya, discuss argya po niya kanina, to ensure that learners are fairly assessed and graded in the continuation of education during this health crisis. Then number two is to emphasize that learning standards shall be attained with the provision of reasonable leniency and considerations for possible difficulties met by the learners. Dirita sa procedures. Assessment as a shared responsibility. As I said a while ago, that this assessment is a shared responsibility among the teachers, the learners, and the parents. So patag-usa na to na agyoy responsibilidad para sa learning sa atong mga bata. So this distance learning poses challenges for teachers and learners in the conduct of assessment, including limitations on giving immediate feedback and the need to account for different contexts in designing, implementing, and grading assessment tasks. So to address these challenges, learners and teachers and parents or guardians, each should have significant roles and responsibilities. Now, dito sa teacher, unsa may mga responsibilities sa teacher? One is design the assessment to allow for flexibility in multiple modalities. Diri sa tuwa kay, although nakay RBI or radio-based instruction, pero ang pinaka-focus dyan, especially those areas nga walay signal sa radio, so dito ra ginaka-focus sa modular, no? Modular. Some also have kuan access to the TVI or TV television instruction, or based television based in instruction. So the teachers should design the assessment to allow flexibility. So flexible ang atong mga teachers, dili na nato na ato bang kumbaga atong tan-awon kung unsay angay nga ihatag nato nga assessment for that particular pupil or learner. Then communicate to learner and parents, guardians, the parents or guardians the design and standards for grading the assessment. So importante kaayo ni na makigistorya kita sa atong mga learners o sa atong parents ang matong mga pamaagi o mga standards for the grading of kay dapat during the distribution of modules and retrieval of modules siguro dapat nato nga i-communicate ang atong mga ginikanan unsa ang atong pamaagi sa paghatag o grado sa atong mga bata para makasabot pud sila kay karon part naman gid sila sa ato nga learning modality dako kay gid sila nga part sa atong learning modality okay so please don't disregard our parents nga siguro dili sa tanang higayon nga moana sila sa school nga mohatag mo mga instructions or makikommunicate mo nila but please find time dili lang kay pag-abot sa eskwelahan diretso ra pud hatag or usahay pasagdahan ra gyud nato sila diha magkuha ra modules din uli wala gitay gihatag instructions wala tay inputs nga gipanghatag sa atong mga parents so unsa nila pag develop karon unsa nila pag level up sa ilahang responsibility as the your assistant as your assistant in providing the basic learning sa atong mga bata nga wala pasagdahan lang nato sila so I hope karon ato ma-realize kinahanglan jud ang atong presensya although online or unsa man adiha nga pamaagi through text and calls but for the time that they will be having or getting the modules so pwede nga ato sa mo gahintag time para ato sila i-communicate kaya nga nag-prepare tayo sa ating classroom nag-prepare ta nga nagbutang ta dito og 15 ka mga bangko nga dili nato gamiton ato pang gibutang-butangan pa nato please sit here nga ang resulta walay nang lingkod correct dili oh ka-relate jud mo ani ka-relate jud tatanan ani kay ang atong bangko wala na nagamit kay inikuha sa mga modules pasagdahan naman nato wala nato sila gather especially sa mga grade 1 bitaw no sa mga grade 1 teachers giunsa man nato giunsa niyo pagpamaagi na karon ang kuan naghatag ka mo og hints or mga tabang sa mga parents maglisod manggalita nga teacher nga magbuka-buka ka sa atong mga baba di ana unsa una pag kuan ang mga sounds mga letters di ana siguro tagana tug time nga ato pong educate ang ato mga parents nga unsaon pa nila pagtudlo ato ilang module di ka sila kamao ato pataka-taka lang niya ato sila dito nganganga dito grade 1 so please ha ato nang kuanon next set up mechanism to monitor and record progress remotely so in terms of monitoring and record progress siguro gahatag man siguro po tao katong mga form sa mga bata no nga naa sila gihimo nga self monitoring or nag-record sila itong ipanghatag nga kining forms nga sulatan sa mga learners o sa mga bata ano sa mga ginikanan kung unsa nga topic ano man ba sila kung unsa nga topic nga wala nila nasabtan ipasulat na dito na ato dito nga mga kuan auto say tool atong ginagamit give timely constructive and relevant feedback so upon receiving the outputs sa mga bata siguro dili po nato lang ato lang murag i-take for granted lang nato na nga ilang mga trabaho nga wala tay gihimo nga feedback kung maayo ba to okay ba to ilang trabaho ihimo ba nila insakto ba ilang pagtrabaho bantayan nato ni mga kapatid facilitate remediation for learners okay ni na ni discuss man gyapon ni ganina ni Ma'am Gina so for those learners struggling learners kailangan din natin ang pinaka importante nga matagaan po nato sila og remediation for further guidance face to face gani naagi tay daghang mga pupils na atong i-remediate how much more nga karon na ana ta modular na ta ang mga bata na sa balay Okay. Next, assessment as a shared responsibility. Umanata sa teachers, parents, na puti ang guardians. So, mo na yung responsibilidad sa itong mga parents and guardians. Communicate with the teacher to give updates on their child situation, progress, challenges, and encountered. Now, how can we do this? How can we do this? Or how can these parents do this? Kung wala yung communication between the teacher and the parents. Kay wala rapod, wala po yung itawag. Okay lang. Basta makakuha module, makauli sa module, paits na. Okay na. Solve na si teacher. Oh. Ang parents po, siguro maikog po manawag ni ma'am. Dapat kung manawag si mama o si papa, lami yung kay tagtingog. Ay, hello ate, kumusta man? Dili nato pa nun. Dili nato tang tingog nato nga mura pinasuko nga mura nagunsa ka mo diha nga gitawagan nasumpo ang inyong trabaho. So, lagot kay ka. And sometimes also, we must also be considerate. By the time nga ang parents natawag sa atuwa, then gabi ina, ato lang po sigurong sabton. Kay during the daytime, possibly these parents are having their kining mga trabaho. No, sa farm baka ha, offices. So wala sila time nga mo. Ana nga during daytime, dili sila maka-assist sa ilang mga bata. That is why gabi-i na sila makahatag og assistance sa atong mga learners. And then that time nga naa sila gilisdan, manawag sila ninyo, siguro atong buhaton po nato, respond lang yun kuan courteously. Ato silang i-cater. Eh, mauman ni atong trabaho na karon nga panahon. That is the time that we can give assistance to our pupils and our learners. Bisa gabi na, sige lang. Okay lang. Laban lang kita mga teachers. Then, dili ta magminal dita iniktubag. Okay. Communicate, yun na, with the teacher. Ama ito maginikanan mo. Kasi maulaw pa sila yung tawag. Kamu nalay tawag. Then second, guide their children in accomplishing the assessment, task, and monitoring tools designated by their teacher. Yun ang sinabi ko kanina. Meron tayo mga monitoring tools na giatag sa ato mga together with the modules giatag sa ato dito. Ato silang i-guide. Ato silang tabangan kung saan nila pag-accomplish. Okay. Planning the assessment. The assessment activities must be made in the best interest of all learners. So the DepEd, atong departamento, it aims to develop independent learners. Maumanggi na ato nga purpose to produce independent learners ng atong mga bata, in which na tigaw migamay sa among GC kay some schools. Kaya naman to na i-survey, there is a survey on the validation of the limited face-to-face instruction. Basi karong January na anay limited face-to-face na ini. And then in the survey, na dito ang enrollment, and then the next column, kinsa tong mga bata na posibleng mo undergo sa limited face-to-face. And then an instruction there, the instruction there is, i-select lang or identify lang those instructional and struggling learners or sa feel iri na tuon sa tong struggling frustration instructional and frustration katulad sila maoy atong i conduct og limited face to face. Ang independent learner dili na nato maapil sa face to face kining proposed karon, but then ang resulta karon some schools siguro wala po ang teacher ga trabaho, wala po na kuan sa school heads na pakita. Iansira na po diretso, gihurot po ang enrollment, and then sa kuan dito sa instructional struggling, maura gihapon pareharag number. So buot pa sabot nila, i-face to face nila tanan, which is dili pwede. Kay ang gipangayo is katurang instructional and struggling learners. So muna nasayo mi dito na igaw mi dito kay kailangan i-edit dito siya nga data. Dili pwede nga tanan imong enrollment himuon ni undergo ni mo face to face instruction. Katorag yung mga naglisod nga mga bata. Okay. Mingon man kita nga mingon po lang mga teacher gid managi sa tungod na ano na pod miingon ta nga amon reklamo gid pud man gini kana na si Roy nga nganong ano man si lagi i face to face na niya amo awala galisod ra gihapon mi direktor do sa among mga bata ana gina posible mahita mo og ginay metabo mo reklamo na mga gini kana nga wala gi apil lang bata sa face to face pero pasalamat sila amo na lang motivate salamat kay mo ate kay wa mo na apil anit meaning ang inyong mga bata maayo jud na imong bata. Independent na, pwede na siya. She or he can learn independently. So, ana lang. So, these are the activities, assessment activities. Align with the most essential, align with the most essential learning competencies. Unsa man siya? Of course, ang atong assessment kailangan pud lisod pug mo mo ana sana makawas ta dito sa most essential learning competencies. Ipampili na ra ba gina from the atong daghan kaayo mga competencies gisala pa gyud. Gipili pa gyud tong unsa tong pinaka importante nga competencies nga kailangan ma-develop sa mga bata, especially nga ang purpose is magamit sa mga bata in their day-to-day experience or interaction in the community, no? So align with the most essential learning competencies. Then the assessment should focus on tracking progress, learners' progress in relation to the content and performance standards in the curriculum, along with the development of the 21st century skills. The next activity is reliable, valid. Kailang assessment nato ay reliable, valid, and transparent. Reliable assessment requires that clear and consistent processes be followed in developing assessment activities. This is to ensure that if you repeat an assessment activity with the same learners or conduct it in another time, or shall we say, if another teacher conducts the same activity with different learners, you should still get the same result. So diha na to makita kung reliable ba jud na ang imong assessment na gihatag. Na bisan pag imong balik-balikon og hatag sa bata, mao ra gyapon ang resulta. I-conduct nimo other time karon nang ihatag ka karo assessment, then next the following day nihatag na puga assessment, same ranga content or same ranga kwan imong gihatag. Pag lahi na po riyang answer na, something wrong. No, dili siya reliable. Pero kung ihatag nimo the following days, then same wrong result, pakpak mga igsoon, kay nakuha gyud nimo ang imong target. No. Or even if other teacher will conduct the assessment, same ra gyapon ang result. So assessment should assess what the learners actually learn in the classroom. Validity, when we talk about the validity, it ensures that the assessment activities and assessment criteria accurately measure the extent of which learner developed the required competency and meet the standards for their grade level. Okay. Next, assessment are fair, inclusive, and equitable. Assessment activities should consider the learner's race, gender, learning needs, mga learning styles, mga bata, language of learning, abilities or disabilities, cultural background, and socioeconomic status. They must never exclude or take advantage of or disadvantage any individual or group of learners. Kailangan tanan, fair gyud ang atong pag-treat sa mga bata, paghatag sa atong nga assessment activities. Mauna nga kung siguro sa atoa kinsa ka sa atoa nga mga teachers nga nagkandak o kining gitawag na to nga online, although dili siya part sa atong kuan karon, pero basin na ay mga bata ba nga pwede sila nato nga mag-contact, maghatag og instruction through using an online platform. Kay ko na sila internet, sila laptop, So pwede po nato na magamit. Although dili ta na nimo makiter but then na jud kay nabuhat. Next, assessment activities are practical and manageable for both learners and teachers. So learners need time to process new knowledge and practice new skills. This means that assessments should be developed and implemented at appropriate times in the learning process. So assessment must be manageable. Kailangan manageable by the teachers, even in the large classes, so that evidence of new learning is gathered over time and in diverse ways. So kailangan nga manageable ang gito, practical ang atong ihatag nga assessment activities. Next, give learners a range of ways to demonstrate their learning. Tamne. Sa asa kani nga part sa atong assessment ni mahitabo, give learners a range of ways to demonstrate their learning. Dito na ni sa performance nila. Teachers must use a range of assessment methods and activities to give learners many opportunities to demonstrate their learning on the knowledge, understanding, skills, and values defined in the curriculum. Pwede man ta makahatag during sa performance task, no? Ito, naisigutan man ni ganina ni Ma'am Gina ang performance task. Written, pwede, makahimu ka. Mga projects, unsabay, ipahimu-himu ni muna anak. Pero pwede po ka makarequest ang mga bata, especially katong na ay available ng internet sa ilahang. Ipakita, gini mo, ipademonstrate nila. Nagunsa ba na sila, wala ba kayo itawag role-playing, baka na diha, or na ba sila gihimu ang bata na mag-recite ng anak. Pwede na ito na siya magamit. And provide timely and accurate information as a basis for feedback. Teachers give ongoing and explicit feedback. Klaruan dyan nato ang atong paghatag og feedback sa mga bata throughout the learning and assessment process. Telling them what they have done well. Ayan. So kinahanglan, importante bi po kayo ng daigdaigon ta nga atong trabaho, gidayik po ba? Okay, kapoy kayo na magtrabaho ta. Bisa kini mga asawa, bitaw? Trabaho sa balay? Ni ang bana wag itay pake basta lang magluto ka on ra podayon wag gyud niya ah, kanindot sa imong kalamia sa imong sabaw langga oy lami kayo gang murag gyud katong sabaw dito sa kuan sa nang agi nang kuan na kanang lami kayo nga lami kayo nga halang halang sa pagdian mo nga na ba na kay balud ta mo daig-daig pud. Og maot pag nilutoan tong asawa, ayaw po, ritsua po taon og liog. Maingon na po ka nga, ala, lamiasa yung tinulag ang, uy, labi na kung nadugang-dugangan ni gamay ng asin, ah, mas mulami pagi kain eh. Ana, pero ang buot pasabot ato, tabang di ay, ano po, samay mong luto, uy, maot, ay, tabang man kayo. Ano po, may mga nga, ah, unsa po ning sabawa, ning dagat, ug parat po, ingon po ni mga lalamihan ni nga, kung ano eh, sabaw. Sa mga tanig magkuha-kuhaan ni gamay ng asin, ah, mas mulami pagkikain eh. O, mana po dito asawa, kasabot na po na asawa. O, at least dili ka maka-hurt sa iyang feelings. Yeah. Ang lang. So, diri man ito nabot, manunta din sa asawa ko ano eh. Dirita sa timely, accurate information as a basis for your feedback. So, teachers also use assessment data to reflect on, modify, and improve their teaching practice. So, unsa man nila pagkaibalo kung wala tay gihimo wala tay gihatag nila nga feedback sa ilang gitrabaho. So, di sila kabalo nga insakto dito ilang ibuhat. What other things need improvement? Manana. And choosing assessment methods. O, natay mga assessment methods nga atong pwede na to nga gamiton, no? Ini siya. Upat ka buok. Observation, talking to learners, analyzing products, and tests. Oh. Unsa may buhato na ni may observation. Kung may tag assessment methods, these are the ways you gather evidence of learners' progress over time. No? These four assessment methods commonly used to find out what learners know and understand. that is knowledge, and what they can do. That is skills, no? So mauni siya ang atong mga methods nga pwede gamiton. Observation. Magunsa man ta ani? Teachers make formal and informal observations of the learners' performance or behaviors based on assessment criteria. Mo na to akong giingon ganina nga karon kay ga modular man ta, wala man tay face to face. Pero mag face to face ta, adali ra kayo kay sa atong classroom makita man dayon, magpa role play ka diha, magpa recite ka diha, automatic kita din mong mga bata mapaka-perform. But this time, so nadyo tay adjustment nga may tabo. Okay, depende kung, depende sa status ato mga bata in terms of internet connectivity, mga gadgets, something like that. So unsa may mga examples nga atong himuon aning observations. Pwede ni siya og investigative activities, no? Role plays, oral presentations. So observaran ni mga bata. Dances, yan. That's part of the observation method. Musical performances, skills demonstrations, or group activities. Kung naa panalitan, magkuhin ka group activities like choral reading, nana, debates, oh, pwede po siya debates. Motor and psychomotor games, simulation activities, mga science experiments. So those are some of the activities nga pwede magamit nato in this kind of method observation. Next is talking to learners. Ah, when umintag talking, so mag-inistory, hayra kita ani, no? Naanagin, i-contact na ginato ang bata. So talking to learners, teachers talk to and question learners to gain insights on their understanding and progress and to clarify their thinking. This is also often referred to as conferencing. So mag-conference mo sa bata. Oh, usa ni siya sa assessment method ah, na mag-istorya kita sa bata para makuha nato ma will be able to evaluate kung nakat-on ba gining bata. Ah. So, may example ani mga activity ngayon mo na to. Oh, pwede discussion, mag-discussion through using comic strips or story trails. Panel discussion, pwede siya. Interview, yan. Interview, think, pair, share activities, or even reading. Okay, those are some of the activities pwede nato siya magamit. Next is analyzing products. Analysis of learners' products. Teachers judge the quality of products created by learners according to agreed upon criteria. So nagpahimo ka kuan sa bata, nakigipahimo sa bata. That is performance na niya part. Drawing ba ka diha? So dapat naakay before pugka mag hatag ani nga kind of activity, dapat naakay gihimo nga rubrics. Rubrics gina kinahanglan basta kay mga performance na ang isgutan. So you as a teacher judge the quality of products or outputs that children or the learners have submitted or made. Examples for this: worksheet for all learning areas, ayan, essays, concept maps, graphic organizer, projects, artworks, pwede po multimedia presentation. Sa high school, murag daghan kay nakita nga ang mga high school naghimo sila ka ng mga video bitaw, mga vlogs, o ayan, pwede na siya. Pero sa elementary, pwede siguro sa grade 6, pero sa lower grades, mag-listen sila na. Pangilang. Kwan, muna nga, ako sa sumasa kong yun ganina, nga naatay variety of assessment strategies. Daghan kay tanim mo, hindi lang kay isa. Products made in technical vocational learning areas. Okay. Next, test. Kining test kay common ra kaini. Teacher set quizzes. Mamunin kasagaran na to. Kaya kapuyan naman ta itong mga uban pa rin ang mga assessment nga ihatag. Test na yun. Paper pencil na dayon. Get one fourth na dayon. Kuhan. Kuha papel, bullpen, ana. Test. Nasa itong una na, mauna to. Tinod bang put part, magin put siya sa assessment. Pero dili lang dapat nga katuloy balik-balik ko na to. Para na po'y gamay nga twist. ma-enjoy po ng mga bata, ma-encourage po sila to do the assessment or to do the activities. Examples for this is mga mga pen and paper test, pre and post test, diagnostic test, oral test. Okay, so these are the four types of assessment methods. How do I know if a child is learning? Moni, unsa ano pagkaibalo nato nga ang bata nakat-on? So diri na nata mosulod ang formative assessment, a process that involves teachers using evidence about what learners know and can do to inform and improve their teaching. Moni atong ito assessment for learning. So kini assessment for learning under niya sa formative assessment, as well as the assessment as learning, in which through the teacher's immediate feedback enables students to take responsibility of their own learning and identify areas where they do well and where they need help. So unsa man jud ka importante ang formative assessment. Kini man gud nga kind of assessment diri nato makbal-an kung sa imong pagtudlo nakat-on ba ang mga bata. Now question ako. Okay, ani. Saan ni din balik? Skip. Ah, gitu. Sige sa ha. Okay. Alam ko'y pangutana na kinahalan ako mga mutubag mo through the chat box. Kanus amat tabo in a part of our lesson, balitan ga, classic kakaroon. Kanus aman may tabo ning formative assessment? Sa imong part, sa imong lesson diha. Sige daw be, i-chat daw sa inyong kuan. Butan daw sa inyong group chat, as group chat, chat box. Pwede makapangayo soft copy sa slide. Sure. Oh, natay mga answer diri. Lain lahi pag answer. Kanus ana to himuon ni formative assessment? Sige daw be mga kaubanan sa buhat. Mga igsoon. Tong magklase mo kanus ani niyo ni himuon ning formative assessment? Naata diri na before, during, after the lesson, right after the lesson, after the discussion, after the lesson, every time, after discussion, after the lesson, before, during, and after the lesson. Oh, lain-lain answer no. So wala kita nagkaiusa ani nga part sa ato nga assessment. So lain-lain ato ang pamaagi di ay sa ato nga classroom. Apo last session of the lesson, before, during, after. Okay. Diba ang atong tumong is to get, to identify, to evaluate the learning, makibala, makuha na ito kung bata, nakat-on ba. So this formative assessment can be done even before the lesson proper or during the discussion and after the discussion. So balik ko na ito. Kumbaga, kini na isa din ni answer si Kwan, no? Sir, kisa ito nakabasa na ako every time. Nakabasa ko na every time. So every time, pwede siya. Yes, every time. Gikan sa pagsugod, tunga-tunga, hantod mahuman ang imong lesson, pwede ka, you can provide formative assessment. That is to assess. So that you can make adjustments sa imong lesson. Oh, during this discussion, you can ask questions or unsa imong activity ngay moon. That's part of assessment na nakat-on ang bata o wala. Kay og wala siya nakat-on sa imong gihimo nga strategy, kay kang strategy man good sa lesson nato, pwede nato na siya mausab sa pag-actual na ni mga discussion. Uy, wa man kasabot sila aning ako pamaagi, oy. So, as a teacher, naadyut kailangan na jud ka nga update. No? So ingon na, assessment, formative assessment can be done before nimo introduce imong new lesson. You can activate the prior knowledge of the child. That's part of learning, no? That is assessment for learning. Before the discussion and during the discussion, nag-discuss na ka ana. Then nangutana ka, mutana. Part na siya sa formative assessment. Usually man gud atong nahunahan man gud ang assessment, ang formative assessment kanang magtesta ang mga bata nga magsulat sa papel ingon ana then mo answer na sila dito letter A letter B moram na kasagaran gud sa tunhona nga mauna na sa formative assessment. But it's not. Ang formative assessment, pwede nimo mahatag anytime, no? Sa mga lesson. Eh, i-assess man nimo ang bata kung nakataon ba o wala. Sige lang kag yama-yama diha. Wala kay gihimong assessment nila during the discussion. Yan, kabalo ka ka, nakataon sila, wala. Ito, di. Pero gihimo man ato na. Nahimo na ato na actually. Pero lang, sa atong una-una lang, nga, ang kininga ko, andito na dito sa after the lesson na to, ang atong formative gihimo. Not knowing nga tanan natong gibuhat during our actual demonstration discussion, naghatag na tag formative assessment. Okay. So ana ha. Then yun na nga sinabi, teachers should give immediate feedback, enable students to take responsibility of their own learning. So that at the time nga mohatag kanila feedback na ana mali or dili, sakto ilang answer, so sila sa lang kaugalingon sa maka napos sila rin ah maka ma-improve nila bali ang ilang naibalaan ay sa dito sa yung ko aning apart ani ana. And then you also as the teacher can make adjustments, so it helps kini nga formative assessment, it helps to improve the learning of all learners while they learn. Learners also develop an understanding of what is involved in their ka naman ni mo pop up ani eh involved in their learning and how to take responsibility to improve. Yun na sinabi ko kanina. So the assessment for learning is ongoing assessment that allows teachers to monitor students on a day-to-day basis and modify their teaching based on what the students need to be successful. Yeah, another question. Another question ako. Ang formative assessment, ato siyang i-appeal sa computation sa grades or yes or no? Ang result sa atong formative assessment, ato siyang i-appeal sa computation sa grade, yes or no? Answer daw sa chat box. Atong result nila silang test, nagpa-testa nila. 10 item test, 5 item test, ana. Okay. Oh, dagha na ni answer. Excuse me. Okay, thank you. So, at least dirita na kasi nabot di ani na ang results ato ang formative assessment kung nagpahimo kag paper and pencil test after sa imong lesson. Result ato, although ato siyang kwaon, pwede na to siya i-record kung ganahan ka mag-record. That, but the purpose is to track the learner's understanding. Sabi ni Eugenie, i-track nimo ang learner's progress, ang learning sa ato mga bata. But not for the computation of grades. Pwede siya i-record kay aron makabalo ka kikma. Okay na, maayo ba? Unsay unsay bara tracking tracking record lang sa imong mga bata in terms of learning. Kay basin ba og kapuyan na ta dito mo na pwede appeal nimo dito input dito sa input dito sa electronic kuan class record para lari grado dito na sa kuan dili ha dili jan. Okay, padayon ta. Next. Makita pa ba niya akong slides? Okay. Formative assessment gyapon. Where is the learner going? Ayan, mauni atong kanon. Where is the learner right now? Asa na sila karon sa imong lesson o sa imong pagkuan? How will the learner? The purpose of this is make adjustments, to make adjustments, make adjustments of your teaching strategy. Okay, magbalik-balik ang buka anak sa imong gibuhat bisag wala na nakasinabot, wala na mo nakasinabot sa bata. Wala yun tayo makuha na na. Ayan, so ito na sample techniques for each formative assessment strategy. Natay gitawag og asynchronous and synchronous type of kuan giving assessment. Unsa may pasabutan ni asynchronous? It could be a form of email, text or mobile or through social media. Whereas ang kining asynchronous man good sa una siya pagkuan ha, pag explain. Asynchronous is online distance kanang kuan that happens. It happens. No. Bali. Ang asynchronous, the learning does not require real time no interaction. Unay asynchronous dili siya kinahanglan nga ikaw as a teacher o ang bata naagyo na at the same time magatubang, no? It does not require real time interaction. Instead, the content is available online na for students to access when it's best suit to their kanus sa sila gusto nga. Well, basta kay imo nang siyang gihabutan hatag dito through email baka ha, or text messages nga pwede makita sa bata anytime. So that is asynchronous. Unsay lang available nga time. Whereas kining synchronous, synchronize ato pagadungan jud. There is a presence of the teacher and the learners at the same time. Mao na say synchronous. So it happens in real time, often with a set class scheduled and required login time. So anang orasa may gusto ka nga, anang orasa magkuanta ha. Atay imoon mun ani. So pwede sa phone call, sa video call, sa ana live chat. That's the difference between asynchronous and synchronous. So makita ra ninyo, dili na ko nabasahon isa-isa. Makita ninyo dito sa DepEd order na ani dito. Formative assessment should be specific, frequent, repetitive, and free from the restriction from grading. Should target skills that are necessary to the attainment of learning competence and measure summative. Dito sa summative assessment. Summative assessment usually administered toward the end of a learning period to measure the extent to which the learners have mastered the essential learning competencies. The results of which are recorded, ito na yung recorded, and are used to report the learner's achievement. Ito na yung summative assessment. Na pwede na nato ma-appeal sa computation of grades. And ganina, kung if you still remember, according to Ma'am Gina sa iyang slide, na sa slides, nga in one quarter, pwede mo makahatag o upat ka summative assessment that involves two weeks. After 2 weeks, you can give or provide summative assessment. No. So for written works, to assess essential knowledge and understanding through quizzes and long unit tests to be composed of items distributed across the cognitive process dimensions using a combination of selected response and conducted response formats. So atong summative assessment po, kan po kayo ni bantayanan, it's very critical kay basic ang atong mga questions na puros lang po understanding. No, dapat katong dito sa Bloom's of Taxonomy na ato ba sulod to nato sa ato ang summative assessment. That is why importante kaayo nga before tanagkuha naagitay TOS table of specification, no? Ay, kabalo naman master na kay mo ana. Dili na ko ni na balik-balik ra maguni ay. Uman na man ni ganina. Performance task uman na po ni Gina ganina. Diri na ta mga sample ng mga summative assessment, no? Activities sa in different learning areas. Sa language, just kuan na pa dila na ko jud kuan untanan. Within your picturean. Written output, pwede ka book, reviews, essays, journals, reports. Sa mga sa products, na campaign, case studies, collage, composition, etc. Multimedia na portfolios. Performance task, so guided na mo dire. Pwede mo dire makakuha unsa inyong mga possible activities nga ihatag or for assessment. Debates, interviews, multimedia presentation, panel discussion, presentation, project making, role plays. That's for language. Direta, direta. Kaya ito ay is modular learning. Online man ito ganina di ay. Direta sa digital modular learning, TVI, homeschooling. Naragaya po ito ganina ang mga activities suggested. Performance tasks, interviews, multimedia, project making. Mathematics, for written outputs, data recording and analysis, geometric and statistical, graphs, charts, maps, problem set, surveys. For products, diagrams, mathematical investigatory projects, models, suggested lang isang mga activities. For performance-based tasks, constructing graphs from survey, multimedia, yung mawala multimedia presentation, no? Outdoor math probability, experiments, problem posing, ayan. Use of manipulatives to show math concepts. For science, like concept maps, recording, laboratory, surveys, or gusto ka katong na makita ng products outputs, investigatory projects, models, diagrams, ayan. Research papers. For performance-based tasks, designing implementation of action plans, designing various models, doing scientific investigations, issue awareness campaigns, laboratory activity. It could also be multimedia presentations for science simulation, skills demonstration. Araling panlipunan, nagihapon ng concept map, essays, journal, for the written outputs, news writing, news article. Mayo kayong mga, itong mga journalist, ani. For the products, we have collage, diorama, leaflet, poster, slogan making, map construction, research work, timeliness, documentary, etc. Then, for the performance task, community involvement, interviews, issue awareness campaigns, reporting, news reporting, okay. Then, the music. Hindi na ako nabasahan tanan, basta mauna siya yung mga sample, arts. Physical education, so physical education, nagya po essays for written outputs, reaction, reflection paper, research paper, for products, article, journal review, personal fitness and health logs, portfolio. Performance of personalized exercise programs, physical activity participation, physical activity fitness assessment or skills demonstration. Let me nag saya PE ni mo, sayaw imong kuan, pasayaw gyud ka diha, mosayaw gyud ang mga bata, or magkuan baka ka, mag-require kanila og entry sa TikTok, pwede, or magamit ang TikTok sa mga bata. Health, ayan, health. Hindi na ako na isa-isahon kay, na ano, makita raman na ninyo, naara na dito. IPP, mauni siya yung mga summative assessment. Pwede din mo magamit. Mura din ganina. Di balik rin eh. This is a sample integrative performance task. Target subject, grade 11. Core subject, oral communication, general mathematics, earth, and life science. Empowerment technologies, understanding culture, society and politics, and physical education. Time frame for the MELC week 1, integrated most essential learning competencies. A subject is oral communication. Then the MELC explains the functions, nature, and process of communication. Budget of work, week 1. General mathematics, nadia ang MELC, dayong asasya nga week. So more on performance tasks. It must be designed to provide opportunity for learners to to apply what they are learning to real life situations. Must be accompanied with clear directions and appropriate scoring tools to help learners demonstrate their learning. Una nga, dili kita maghatag og performance task kung wala tay rubrics nga atong sundon. Kay sige, mata-mata ra pud kadiha. Muna-muna na taon sa mga batag perform. Pero ikaw, mata-mata ra ka og hatag nila og kuan rating or unsa ba. So, dapat na jud kay rubrics nga dapat makabalo pud sila. Nga mauna sila ang ilang sundon para during their performance guided sila unsa ilang maayong nga buhaton para modako-dako pud ilang grado sa imuha yatag score baka ha. Preferred to be collaboratively designed and implemented, integrating two or more competencies within or across subject areas. So as a while ago si Ma'am Gina, guys, good pahin ani sa integration of subjects, no, in doing the performance task nga pwede siya nga na, nag-involve og pipila ka mga subject matters or subject matters, learning areas or subjects, no. To be accomplished flexibly, to consider time and available resources. Balik-balik naman eh. Teacher professional judgment matters. Teacher's professional judgment. Gilinginan yun. Insightful decisions informed by professional knowledge of curriculum expectations, context, evidence of learning, methods of instruction and assessment, and the criteria and standards that indicate success in student learning. Ontario Ministry of Education. Yan kini ra pong ko ano, usahay pod kita mga teachers, likayan po nato na nga anang itawag anang mag-perform or naay bata nga mag-perform tungod kay imuhang suod or silingan best friend ni miyang mama, bisag dili kay siya maayo nga mo perform imo gidako gid niya kuan kay tungod lagi ngon ni ana imo ang best friend besi ni mo ang iyang mama, tagaan ka pirmi og cake og kuan hatdan ka pirmi mag gastos sa ang balay. Itaw ikaw muna bahala anak kay balo na mo anak mga teacher. Conducting assessment remotely, objectives of the assessment tasks, roles of learners and parents, guardians, procedures and expected timeline, standards and rubrics. Consult learners and, when necessary, parents, guardians to allow room for adjustment flexibilities needed if any. So dili pud kay ta mag-instrikto, mag-igsoon sa atong, labi na sa atong na time karon nga maglisod po tao ng mga parents. Dapat flexible po tayo, kay balo po tayo mag-consider sa status sa ato mga parents, especially kato mga parents gitaon na to nga galisod gitaon, bisa maingon nga sa sila mismo galisod taon og sabot-sabot atong ato ang module. So mauna nga dili pod nato sila ato gitabangan, mao nang ingon nga tinabangay ra kita ining panahon karon. Self monitoring tool, naghatag pa ta ani na i-sample ani nga self monitoring tool dito sa kuan depend order. Anawalan niyo to, na-sample dito ani nga form. Na dito, sample sa dito nga, unsay nga subject, ang unsay nga part sa lesson nga naglisod sila. Ayun, na po dito nga, nahuman ba sa bata, ang ilang module, na dito tanan. A feedback to benefit students' learning, both formative and assessment must be accompanied with timely, constructive, and meaningful feedback. Importante na, balik-balik na taaning feedbacking. Kailangan, importante kay ni dili lang kanato nga ato lang i-danok sa daplin itong mga output sa mga bata, nga wala tayo gihimo nga feedback sa ilaha. Why constructive nga feedback na itong gihatag sa ilaha. Dapat timely. When it's timely, ayop na paabuti o ato pang kanusa pa ng anyuhan ninyo ihatag ang feedback sa atong mga bata o sa karon sa atong mga parents. Money ang mga flow, pwede mga flow sa atong mga feedback. Oh? Does his, her answer meet the success criteria? If his or her answer correct, incorrect, proceed. Pag correct, what did she do well? Nana ng paghatag feedback na to, no? Try to follow any question. Pag ang correct ang mga responses, nana po sunod nga pangutana. What did he or she do well? Pag incorrect po siya, how can she elaborate on the answer? Where did she go wrong? Di na dyan ninyo mabasa di ba? Kay, what is the correct answer? What's information? Mo ni siya feedbacking or maghatag na itong feedback. No? Pwede guided tani, pwede na ito ni siya magamit. Then, padayon ta itong correct answer, unsa iyang gihimo, nga maayo, then unsa nga strategies did he use? What other questions can be asked about the task? Ayan. Pag wrong yang responses, what is wrong and why? What is the explanation for the correct answer? Ayan. What are the relationship with the other parts of the task? Okay. So, ingon ana. Remediation. Balik na po ang word ng remediation. Ano mang gining word ng remediation, di gini siya mawala. Because also put one of our responsibilities is to really help the pupils. Nga dili lang kay ganahan lang ta sa mga bata na kamao ug maglagot na dayon ta atong di kamao. Nya kinira pong bata nga kuano sahay pag slow bitaw jud kayong bata nga struggling mao panoy anang murag mahasngan sa labi na maglagot ng maestra gikan sa balay or di ba ka kining mga single di ana nga nag-away siyang uyab pag-abot sa eskwelahan ang katunay ng mga tawo na mga struggling learners mo ay mahimungtan bisag unsa na lay mayaw-yaw anton mulapas na ta sa child friendly no ang katawan pero katawan mga bright dito may kayo gisuod-suod og maayo mapanoy sige kuan istoryahon. So kini ato mga kuan mga struggling learners nato ato dyan yung tabangan. Consistent with DO8 series of 2015, teachers should ensure that learners receive remediation when they earn raw scores which are consistently below expectations in summative assessment by the fifth week of any quarter. This will prevent a student from failing any learning area at the end of the year. Dayon, pagkakuan na dayon, pag mabagsak na dayon, ma-fail na ang bata katapusan, ang resulta, mapangutana na po sa inyo, ha, sa ato ang mga teacher, unsa day atong gibuhat, nganong na-fail man niya ang bata? Recall ka, naapatay gibuhat atong mga niagi nga naapatay interaction or contact sa mga bata, naapatay gihimo nga remediation, itabangan ba nato siya or gipasagdahan? Sagdahan lang. Low siya kuha, gibisag nakita na nimo nga gagmay taon kay mga bata, luoy kayo o itrack nimo ang iyang records, luoy taon kay mga resulta. Dayon, ang pangutana, naapatay gihimo para matabangan nato siya. So, mao na siya atong i-reflect sa atong kagulingon. Dayon pagdaghan na dayon kayo og failure, I remember one time nga checking to siya sa forms. Dayon grade 6 man ko sa una. Kaya na dito'y na-fail nga bata. So, i-questionon ka. Ano maning na bagsak maning bata, pila ka adlaw sa eskwela dito, naabot pa og 200 days or 190 kapin, nabalik-balik sa eskwelahan, o nga nung nabagsak pag yun? Mapangutana na dahin ta. Ano nabagsak mani? Unsa dahi gibuhat na to? Okay. Thank you very much. Nahuman ragyan. Okay. So ang ato mga question sa i-park lang nato niya para ma-proceed ta. Okay, ang ato nga since our time right now it's 20 minutes past 11 o'clock. So let's proceed to the next speaker. Thank you very much for listening. Our next speaker is the last speaker. Session 3. Okay, our last session, our third topic for this morning's webinar, it's all about the grading procedures. Yes, ma'am. Let's welcome our very active principal of Laureano Salusa National High School, Mr. Pedro Languido. Sir, it's your time.
Wala yung suksukanan man diri, Jim.
Diya, Jim.
Naguro sa Pinas. Pwede na po, di na ka magamit.
Hindi na. Iyon lang ang microphone.
Presenta.
Okay, Sir Pets, you can now start presenting.
Okay, hindi ko na.
Sorry, para sa
lahat. Paano diyan?
Kung ba nag-open this set, may idea niya?
Nauna, oo, oh, una. Dito ta sa akin, slide show.
Tingo sa Sir Nam, okay. I presenting?
Sir Yon, good morning, I am presenting.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Sa beginning, okay.
Thank you na gani, sir, oh.
Thank you naman. Sa slide show.
Okay.
The beginning. Okay. Okay, good morning to all of us in this present in this platform. My presentation, my slides, I have 30 slides because it is already 12:23. I will make my presentation into 25 to 30 minutes because
11, as well, 11.
During 11. Statement of purpose that we I'm going to give enough time for open forum or question and answer so that what is not transpired during the delivery of speakers will be transpired, will be understood. So grading procedure on DepEd Order 31 series of 2020. The following will be discussed in this session: assessment components, quarterly assessment, weight distribution of assessment components per learning area for grades 1 to 10, and weight distribution of assessment components per learning area for senior high school. Now, for written works, written works and performance test. It is this written works and performance assess content and performance standard, and the assessment and performance task for summative assessment will have a minimum of 4 per quarter, and this should be integrative if possible, meaning if a teacher can make an integrative assessment, include that in maybe includes math, science, or English in one assessment, and that is good, suggested. The next is of course in this DepEd order we are not it is suggested that we will not make a quarterly exam. But instead, based on the schedule of DepEd Order 7 and interim DepEd Order 30 about the school calendar, that the schedule for quarterly exam will be focused on major performance tasks, okay, in lieu of the quarterly exam. Now, this is now the distribution of the summative assessment components per learning area for grade 1 to 10. So for language, EP and ESP, It is 40-60. And for science and math, we have 50-50. And for MAPI and EEP and TLE, it's 30-70. We all know that in Dipped Order 8, we have 20% of the quarterly exam. And this is evenly distributed to written works and performance tasks. 10% added to performance tasks and 10% added to written works. But there are subjects, especially MAPI and TLE, the quarterly exam percentage on Dipped Order 8 focus on performance tasks. Okay, weight distribution of the summative assessment components for senior high school. Now, for all subject areas, as all subject, you have the 40-80. But for the work immersion, research, business enterprise, and others, it's 50-50. For technical, vocational, and livelihood, no, this those 40-60 and 50-50 for academic track, but for technical, vocational, and livelihood is 30-70. 30 for written works and 70 for performance tasks. So the same lang, the same. The distribution of points is still 40-60, 50-50, and 30-70. You just look onto your subject, what percentage that you are going to use in your class record. Okay, example. Sample competition of written works and performance tasks in language. The first presentation that you will be having a 40-60. Now, if the total score is 85 and learner A gets 77 in 4 suggested works and written works, the students will earn only 36.4% because this is only 40%. And for performance task, which is 60%, if the total score is 75 and the student will get only 56, the students will get only 45%. And then the initial grade will be 81%. That is, if we are going to add 36.4 and 45% of the score, that because that it will give us 81.4%. And the quarterly grade based on the transmutation on Dipped Order 8, the students will have 88 as his grade in the report card. The same true with math science for grade 1 to 10. 50-50, so very easy. Only is that we need to transmute the initial grade, what is the average, the percentage of grades to the quarterly grade based on Dipped Order 8 transmutation table. Okay, the same AP, MAPI, AP, and TLE for 50-50. Okay, the same. I know, wrong itong nandoon sa slides. Kasi, as what I've said, in MAPI and TLE and EEP, performance task is 50. Pero dito sa sample, dito na sa baba, tama naman, 30-70. So, get corrected na lang ang doon ang slides. Because ang nag-prepare nito ay ang central office. So, transmutation of grades will follow Appendix B of the Dipped Order 8. Now, policy on retention and promotion will still follow provision on Dipped Order 8, 2015. So, meaning 60% the students get in their performance, then it will be promoted because that is 75%. That is already 75. No, because the lowest scores that the students get to pass is 60 and got a 75 as a grade in their promotions based on the transmutation on Appendix B of the DepEd Order 8/2015. Now, the role of technology and assessment and grading. Now, technology plays a substantial role in helping teachers in the development, communication, and implementation and grading of assessment tasks. So very important, in grading task technology, Calc or Excel will help us. So we have to develop our e-class record for us to be of help, to be helped in terms of computation of grades. Because we can program or we can make a computation directly based on the DepEd Order 8 transmutation table. Now this is now our DepEd Order 8 transmutation table. As what I've said, if the students get 60 as initial grade, 60 to 61.59, then the student can pass the subject. That is 75. That is the lowest 60. No, so that's why when A-class record will be programmed based on this DepEd Order 8 transmutation table. Now the technology also and give us or help us as our assessment resources. We have the low technology, we have the medium technology and high technology. What are these? So the printed supplemental activities and assessment, these are considered as low technology. Flashcard, pop-up books, but the medium technology, we have here, we have SMS, or mag-texta, or maybe chat, or radio. Dagan kayo na example, voice memo. For high technology, of course, the students or the teachers provides PowerPoint, Excel or computing of numbers using Excel. We have different high technology way of assessment. So we have three, no? Low technology, kanara yung mga iswat lang nato, directly black and white. We have the medium technology and the high technology using now our gadget. Well, these are examples, no? So mga quick rubrics na ay mga link that you can use in this DepEd Order 31. Suggested link that you can use for us to give good practices, teaching practices in our students, especially in evaluation of students' performance. Mga Emodo, Class Dojo, Duho, there are many suggested, YouTube or whatever. For as long as you are very good in technology, you can browse this link. No, we have here, suggested, I will make it fast para matagaan tagkuan. Anyway, di magyapon eh. Now, monitoring and evaluation. For monitoring and evaluation, school heads to oversee compliance of the school level. So meaning the school heads shall primarily responsible for the supervising and the implementation of this policy in their schools. So teacher, school heads has a very great role in this, in the implementation of DepEd Order 31. And of course, our division office is also monitor on this, the implementation or compliance of schools. We have the division office will get feedback from the schools and then submit to our regional office, and then the regional office give feedback to the central office, and then the central office to evaluate the policy if necessary. The school head shall be primarily responsible for supervising the implementation of this policy in the schools, ensuring that the provision of the are communicated to all concerned stakeholders in the school committee. Meaning, there should be time that we are going to cascade or inform our parents about this order, so that they will know also. No, the region and school division office shall jointly monitor the compliance of schools with these guidelines. At the school level, the implementation of this policy shall be monitored and evaluated at least once every quarter by the school head. So, take note, all teachers, that the school heads will evaluate the output of this policy. So, for me, as a school head, if the teachers present me the output of the teachers, I will look for their assessment tool and the rubric and sample test result, assessment result of the students. Sa ingon niyo ni, dili lagi siya pwede, ihangad-hangad lang. No, the school head shall prepare quarterly report. So how could the school head make or prepare a quarterly report if the school head will not monitor? So that the school head can write down all the challenges and issues encountered throughout the policy implementation. Of course, as what I've said, the report will be submitted to the division office through our district supervisor for their analysis. And then the SDO will prepare a biannual analysis report for submission to the regional office, and overall policy feedback from the regional official is provided to the DepEd Central for their evaluation. Now, this is a sample self-monitoring tool that it is not really required or mandated, but it is highly recommended by this DepEd order that the teacher will issue this format to our parents, so that in this part, on this presentation, this will be the part of the students that the students will check, no, what the students will do from Monday to Saturday. And the next slides for the parents will check also how far or nagawa ba ng bata na mag-isa o nagawa ba ng bata na may tulong ng iba ang sinulat niyang gawin sa Lunes o ang sinulat niyang gawin sa Martes. This is tracking, a self-monitoring tool. And this must be suggested to, you know, highly recommended that the teacher will print out this and give to the parents, so that this will be a tool for them to guide. Now for The teachers will write their comments, no, mga komento at sagot. So in this tool, next is sample self monitoring. May para sa students, may para sa parents, mayroon din sa teacher. This is the slides. The two slides added by the regional office. Okay. Upon recommendation by SDOs, after consultation with the school under the respective